Hello everyone, welcome back to the Excel 2016 training. In this video, we'll take a look at the custom filters. Here is our employee's workbook and we will look at custom filters. Now, when it comes to custom filters, you know, as the name says, you're customizing your filter, you can narrow your result. So let us take a look at the last name column. As you can see, I have kind of added color to three columns here on the header. I want to talk about the last name column, which is a text column, date of hire. As you can see, it's a date column. And on the third, which is the salary, which is a numeric column. So when you perform custom filtering, it depends on the data type that you're dealing with. So let us start with the last name. So with the last name, it's a string or it is some text. So what is it you can generally look for? Maybe look for a specific person, which you can always do using the option here. Just type the name. Let's say you want to look for Alex, everyone with the name Alex. So it's done. So it's that simple. But let's say you want to look for someone whose name starts with C. You know, T. Now you would do T. Now the problem here is it pulls every value that contains the letter T, but that is not what we are looking for. We are looking for the name that begins with the letter T. So for that, you will have to go to text filters. Because this is a text column, it says text filters, and it displays you appropriate custom filters that you can apply. Say for example, you know, we were talking about, you know, the last name starting with T, so you can do begin with. When you do that, it automatically picks begin with. You know, we're dealing with last name begins with T, do okay. So now we have all the records where the last name starts with T. Now let's go back here. You can do a few things based on the text, you know, equal to, does not equal to, begin with, end with, contains, does not contain. Now there is, at the bottom, you have custom filters. By the way, all the above are custom filters as well, but this starts with a blank thing where, you know, you can pick something that is more appropriate for your search criteria and enter the value. But when you do a specific thing above this, say contains, so it picks appropriate option for you here by default. So that's what, or that is how you perform a custom filter search here. Now let us go to the date column here, the date of hire. So when you say date, you know, you can pretty much think of, and hey, where date is equal to, or it's before certain date, time, period, or, you know, last week, this week, last year, this year, you know, things like that. Because it is a date, it's not begins with, right? It's a date. So here, once you say date, you have quite a bit of options. You can say, of course, equal to certain date, or, you know, before, after, between, you know, tomorrow, today, yesterday. You know, you have next week, this week, last week. As such, you know, you can have something for month, for the quarter, for the year, year to date, which means, you know, from the beginning of the year till today. And then, of course, you have custom filter. Again, you know, it's similar to the text filters. You get to pick, you know, the right option for you, and then you start entering some values to, you know, to filter the data. Say, for example, here you want to do select all. Let me get the whole data set. So here you can always, you know, I believe you have seen this, you can uncheck this and just display a specific year. So here are the date filters, and let's say you want to do last year. Click that. So now everything came from 2016. Let's go there. You can also do between. So this is after or equal to. So January 18th to 3rd June 25th. Okay, so we do have some here. So you can also pull records based on a date range. So that's the power of the custom filter. Now you can also apply this to a numeric column. When you say numeric column, you can say greater than, equal to, you know, primarily those things comes into picture. For number filters, you have, you know, equals, does not equal, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, between, top 10, above average, below average, and then you have custom filter. Again, these are all custom filters where, you know, you pick a desired one, you have appropriate values selected within the dropdown, so you don't have to, you know, search for a thing. So that's why it comes handy, this section. But if you really want to, you know, go and do some your desired custom filter, you can always go here. Let's say here I want to see everyone above average, so that's the thing now. But here you have two filters applied, one for the date and one for the salary as well. Let's say you want to clear this, then you have quite a bit of records. But let's go back here, do this below average. So yeah, I mean, it does apply the filter. Clear that. Okay, so that's it about the custom filters. You know, spend some time and, you know, I'm sure you'll master this within, you know, maybe 10 to 15 minutes. Well, that's it about the custom filters. I will see you in the next video.